Okay, hello. So in this video, we will be solving problems that involves ratio and proportion. So I intended to have this video to teach my daughter. This is my daughter, Chloe Nicole. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so please read the problem.
A baker needs 2 kilograms of flour for every 3 dozens of pandesal. How many kilograms of flour does he need for every 24 dozens of pandesal?
Okay, so the problem is about. Okay, lang na. The problem is about the baker needs certain amount of flour in every 3 dozens of pandesal. So, let us first translate the problem into ratio and proportion. So, we were given the amount of flour is 2 dozens of pandesal. Diba?
Yes.
Okay. So, flour is 2 dozens of pandesal. So, we will follow this pattern. Now, we will start from flour, the amount of flour, and then the corresponding amount of pandesal that is in dozen. Okay, so from the problem, let us look at what are the amounts given or the values given. Okay, so, ang sama ng mga amount na given sa problem?
2 kilograms okay, for
two
every...
kilograms
for
of, what is that? Four?
For flour for every 3 dozens.
Okay, so we have 2 kilograms is 3 dozens
of pandesal.
So that means the baker can produce 3 dozens of pandesal using 2 kilograms. Okay, now the question is, how many kilograms will he need? How many kilograms of flour will he need if he wants to produce 24 dozens of pandesal? So, I label the amount of flour here. It
okay.
is because that is still a noun. We need to solve this. So, we are going to represent it as X. Okay, did you get it? So,
yes.
For every value or for every quantity that is still unknown pa, or that is the value that we need to solve, we are going to represent it by X. Okay, you look at the pattern. Amount of flour is 2 dozens of pandesal. That is related to kung ilan or how much or how many kilograms of flour if the baker wants to produce 24 dozens of pandesal. Gets?
Yes.
Okay. So, we are going to translate this into numbers. So, that is 2 kilograms is 2. What is this 3?
3.
What is the 3? 3
dozens.
Dozens of pandesal. And we are going to solve the value for this X. That is by how many kilograms of flour if we are going to produce 24 dozens of pandesal. So, how are we going to work on that? So, you need to listen. Okay? So, we are going to multiply the inner and outer. If we say inner, that these are the values inside. Okay? So, to make it clear, let me point out, these are the values inside. So, if we are going to multiply 3 times X, that is, do you know it already? Not yet?
Not
okay,
yet.
So, if we are going to multiply 3 by X, the answer is 3X. Okay, so, after multiplying the inner values, let us now multiply the outer values. Okay,
so,
these are the outer
2
values.
And 24.
Yes, so what is the answer if we are going to multiply 2 and 24? 34.
This would be 8 and 48.
Okay, so that is 48. So we now have 3x is equal to 48. Okay, let me remind you that what we are looking for is the value for x. But this time, our x has a numerical coefficient. Ano yung numerical coefficient? A number right beside x. So we need to eliminate this in order to have the value of x.
Okay.
So how? That is by, okay, if yung x ay merong numerical coefficient, all we have to do is divide both sides by x. That means 3x will be divided by 3. And then the 48 will be divided by 3 also. So what is the result? 3 divided by 3.
1.
Okay. Now, si x, kay mabilin pa na siya.
Yes.
Okay. So if there is no number written beside x, that is understood that the numerical coefficient here is 1. Asa ganin ang 1? 3 divided by 3 is 1. Okay. We are no longer going to write 1. So that is understood already that there is 1 there. Next is 48 divided by 3. The answer is
16.
So that means we now have the value for x, which is, unsay value for sa x nila solve? 16. Okay, what is the 16? That 16 is
16 kilograms.
Okay, 16 kilograms of what? Kilograms
flour.
Of flour. Okay, so that means if the baker wants to produce 24 dozens of pandesal, he needs 16 kilograms. Okay, so the answer to the problem is the baker needs 16 kilograms of flour for every 24 dozens of pandesal. Okay, so nakuha niyo ang pattern how
yes.
Did we solve the problem? Okay, so that is just by simply applying the ratio and proportion concept. Okay, so let us try another problem.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so let's have another problem. So okay, did you enjoy?
Yes.
Okay, so you read this problem.
2 packs of pandesal cost 400 pesos.
That is not
4 pesos.
40
pesos.
Okay.
How much will I pay for 10 packs of pandesals?
Okay, did you get the problem? Do you understand?
If the person buys 2 packs of pandesal, it costs 40 pesos.
Okay.
And
then I touch that one. And
how much?
And he needs to know how much.
Much will he
pay
for 10 packs
of pandesal?
Yes.
Okay. So can you answer it without having some confusion? Can you solve it mentally? No.
Yet.
Not yet?
Yes.
Okay, so let's try to translate the problems into a ratio and proportion format. So from the problem, it says, in every box of pandesal, in every 2 packs of pandesal, it is related to,
cost.
Or associated to the cost. So from the problem, it is given that the 2 packs of pandesal cost how much?
40 pesos.
Okay, now he wants to know if 10 packs of pandesal, what is the cost for the 10 packs of pandesal? Since we didn't know yet how much does it cost, so we represent it by x.
Okay.
So this x is the value that we need to solve that represents for the cost of the 10 packs of pandesal. Okay, did you get me? Did
yes.
You understand? So, if we are going to translate it into numbers para makasolve na ta, remember ka ganina tong problem number one?
Yes.
Okay. Ang mga numbers, kaya ito ang form into ratio and proportion na format. So, parehaan eh. So, unsa man ang unang number dapat isulat na to?
Two packs of pandesals.
Ayun na ng packs. So,
two is to
X. Next, 40.
To 40.
40. So, mahimong nga niya ang itsura.
Okay.
2 is to 40 is equals to 10. Kay 10 mo ni. Is to
blank.
Blank or X. That is unknown. A question mark. So, ganina, I told you to multiply inner and outer. What is inner?
Kanang...
What's inside?
Kanin?
Okay, so this 40 and 10. Okay, that's right. How about the outer?
2 and X.
Okay, so that means we are going to start from inner. 40 times 10. Hey, are you okay?
Excuse me. Yes.
Okay, so what is 40 times 10? 400. Okay, that's 400. And then, if we are going to multiply 2 by X, the answer is...
Kadak.
Is... Ganina natay, 3 times X. The answer is 3X. This time, we multiply 2 by X.
2X.
Okay, so that is 2X. Okay. So, what's next? Diba, we need to find X, but our X has a numerical coefficient of 2. Kasabutan na ng numerical coefficient number sa kilid. Okay. So, what to do para mawala ng 2? Ganina, ang sige, buhat na to ganina.
You divide.
Okay, that's right. Very good. Divide both sides by 2. So, yung anong hitsura? 400 divided by 2. And then 2x divided by 2. So what is the answer?
2x divided by 2, 1. And 400 divided by 2 is? 200.
Okay, that's right. So the answer is 200 is equal to x. So that means?
1.
Okay, 2 divided by 2, 2
is
1. Okay, so this 200 means? This is the cost for the 10 packs of pandesal. So, to answer the question on the problem,
you will pay 200 pesos
for 10
packs of pandesal.
Okay. So, 200 yung mabayaran sa 10 packs of pandesal. Okay. Congratulations.
Yes.
Thank you for watching and our tips for mother, so para makastudy ang mga bata since they want to use gadgets, so make use of that, take advantage of that, so mag-record while you are studying.